We are looking at a full HD black box dash camera. In this case, a model AR790 with two channels. That means there's one camera looking out the front of your car, checking out what's there. Second camera looking out the rear view, the rear window. Or if you want, watching the passengers. That is also an option, what you can do. Like if you're a Lyft driver or whatever other driving thing, a cab driver or whatnot. So you can have one pointed at the street in front of you and one in the cabin, or you have one in the back and the rear to see what's happening back there. We are unboxing this here. And I get all this stuff out, and then we can talk about what this is good for and what this all is. Okay, so let's see. Let's get it all over here. This is the reverse camera, so the camera that is in the back and the rear window to see if you get rear-ended. There's the connection on it. On the right side it has nothing. It has a mount. It's adjustable. And you see here the camera, and there's a little LED. So it's like a theft warn alert thing that people see that you're recording. This is the mount for the windshield. Here is the power cable. Let's take that out. That has to be connected in your fuse box. There's a fuse in this thing itself. There is a ground wire here. If you hold this over here, there's a little label on there. It says ground. Then the yellow one here is battery. So it connects to constant battery power. And then here is the ACC accessory, right? So whenever you turn your radio on or something, so you don't have to do the ignition on, just your radio turns on the ACC and then it starts recording. This is the main and front camera. This is the camera that is recording. It has a few LEDs here, two buttons for an event or to mute the sound, the audio recording, because it's also recording audio. Here's the reverse camera, and there the power. We see, so here there's the power connector. So you have to run this wire from this camera, what you position in the middle of your windshield up front. There's where the power is connected. So you run that to your fuse box. And it's glued to the window with this little plastic piece. The foot itself contains the GPS receiver. It's also adjustable here, so that you can adjust the camera. And here is the port for the SD card. You only have to insert this once, because you can download the video from the camera onto your phone through Wi-Fi. Here's the SD card it comes with. The 16 gigabyte. That lasts for a few drives. How does this open? Oh, here. No. Does it here? Oh, yeah, this way? That way. Okay. There we go. So here's the 16 gigabyte card. Let's insert that text to the top and insert this until it clicks. And then you can close this little rubber thing, the cover again. There we go. Looks smooth and neat. Yeah, as I said, glued to the windshield. GPS receiver in it. There's a little light up front here, so it's a theft light. You can see it's blinking, and then people know there's an alarm in the car or what. That, and then we have here stickers, a bunch. There's two sets for the front window mount and two sets for the rear window, just in case you have to reposition the camera. You want it in the center and as far up on top as you can, so that's not in your field of view. Those two here. And then there's four little stickers to hold the cable. We have a little tool here to tighten the screw once the camera is set. That's that. Look, this kind of sticker goes for the rear camera. Fits there, and then the oval sticker is here for the front window mount, double-sided tape. It never comes loose, I can tell you that. Sorry. So this plastic thing It's easy to remove the camera from it. If you want to take it out for a while. And then we have the manual that describes where to download the app. You can download an app and then download the video to your phone while you're in the car. It's all pretty easy to set up. I can show this in a different video when I do the installation.